Allowing you to present results of our
book.
Our book was carried out in Russia in nonlinear optics laboratory, and that laboratory belongs to South Ural State University, which is located in Chelyabinsk, and Institute of Electrophysics, Ural branch of Russian Academy of Science, and this institute located in Yekaterinburg. That is the picture of South Ural State University, and that is Institute of Electrophysics. Let me to begin with describing the main terminology which will be used in our presentation. You can consider spin-orbit interaction of light as an interaction of three types of angular momentum. All light field have this one kind or two angular momentum. The first one is the spin angular momentum, which is very known in this room, as far as I understand. And the second one is extreme orbital angular momentum. And it's connected with not right trajectory of the light beam. The trajectory can be curved, the cross-section intensity is a little bit smooth, and the phase is ordinary phase principle. And the third, that is very, the first and the second are very known types of angular momentum, but the third type, just not new, but it's known for almost 30 years, and it's connected with the random light intensity distribution is a specific place. And we can see the spin order interaction of light as a pi interactions of the three types of angular momentum of light. That is only this kind of interaction we will be described here. And considering the spin-orbit interaction as a pi interaction, we can put all known effects of spin-orbit interaction in this table. We can see that all part of this table are filled. And here in green are shown those effects which were for the first time observed in our laboratory, and in red what we are going to present today. And the first is the influence of spin angular momentum of an extrinsic orbital angular momentum. It's considered as a shift of Z component of the symmetric beam based under the circular polarization sign change. Let us consider circular polarized light propagation through the half of a lens. And in this case, as it was shown many years ago, there is a transverse shift of the Z component of intensity. It was described by this formula, and we can see that the part of the Z component is very small relatively to the full intensity. And this formula described this distribution. For the first time, this effect was observed many times ago, and we used as a scattering medium special crystal, which was made in Chelyabinsk region, or salt solution. It was impossible to register the intensity distribution in the Z component by using ordinary film camera using salt solution, but it was made in simopal. And that is intensity distribution in the beam base, and this shift was equal to 1.5 micrometer. It was very easy to observe this shift by on site. We can see the change of the position of this waste under the change of sign of support polarization. If we consider this time of spin orbit interaction of light as a breaking of cylindrical symmetry, then we can try to obtain the another effect when our light beam transmitted through one part of the lens, or upper or bottom. In this case, the intensity distribution is a Gaussian ordinary distribution, and as a result, we have got this distribution. The similar as the first time intensity distribution in the waist of the beam, and this shift was equal to 3 micrometer. And the different value depend on the value of the size of the beam waist. And now I'd like to speak about the second. If we have got the influence of spin angular momentum on extrinsic orbital angular momentum, so we can have inverse effect. So influence of extrinsic orbital angular momentum on spin angular orbital momentum. And in this case, we should consider the propagation a linear polarized light through a lens. And linear polarized light can be considered as a superposition of circular polarized light with equal intensity. And in this case, we have got the similar distribution of the light of the Z component of intensity in the phase. And if you put some kind of obstacles in the focal plane from this side or this side, we have got amplitude anisotropy, and in this case we have got elliptical light but not linear polarized light. And let us consider how to estimate the value of ellipticity. If we have got linear polarized light on the input and consider the matrix of circular dichroism, we can obtain the following expression for the output beam. And output beam is elliptically polarized, and it described by angle of ellipse major axis orientation and ellipticity. And using this equation, we can estimate the angle of ellipticity and ellipticity and angle of ellipse major axis orientation. And in this case, in our experimental condition, we have got taken into account the small value of our values. We can obtain that the angle of the orientation is not changed, and ellipticity is equal to the value of the circular dichroism, and that is a little bit 10 to the power minus 4. That is the experimental setup. And we have got a very nice elliptical polarization at the input of our system. It is at ellipticity 10 to the power minus 4. And we have used spectrometer slit as a shutter. And we can put our obstacle in one side of the beam and another side of the beam. As a result, we have got four digitals And you can see that this value all positive, but in our predictions, this value should be negative and positive. But accuracy of our experiment is 2%. In order to understand what is the matter, we used the generalized matrix equivalence theorem, which allow us to consider our ellipticity, our polarization transformation as a combination of four type basic mechanisms. And taking into account that in our experiment the angle of major ellipse axis did not change, and taking into account the small value of polar ellipticity, we can take into account only two metrics and obtain the following expression for the general matrix in our experiment. As a result, averaging of our result, we have got the value of circular dichroism to the power minus 3, but we observed this topological circular dichroism along with the Bayer regions, which have just the same value to the power minus 3. Thank you for your attention.
You know, the propagation of your light through the scattering medium. Can you comment on that? Because my question is, when we have any polarized light that's scattered, the angular momentum will be changed.
Yes, but if we put a polarizer after the scattering medium in a particular direction, that is the polarizer, and this polarizer selects only polarization in this direction. And so we can observe the intensity which have this direction of polarization. It is so close. In this case, it's a pure sense, but I think that it will be possible to think about the possible application.
Okay,
but just now, it's pure science.
The objective of this workshop is to use the twisted photons for biomedical diagnostics. Mm-hmm. So with your degree of sensitivity, because you showed like you can measure the dichroism 10 to the minus 3 here, and can we think in this direction? Like
in order to measure this small ellipticity, we made a new method of measurement of small ellipticities, and I'm going to present these results in the poster session. And I think that these results, which we use in order to obtain our pure scientific results, will can apply it in some field for measuring of small ellipticities.
Mm-hmm.